Hi viewers, welcome to Sports Diary program. In our Sports Diary program, every week we are meeting various international sports players who are hailing from Tamil Nadu. And this week also we are going to meet a young dynamic international sports player from Tamil Nadu. This program is a program which is to inspire public through sports. That is the motive of the program. When the sports player is talking about their profile, career, how they achieve the medals in the tournaments, how they come up from the different challenges. This is what the motto and the objective of the program, to inspire many public. And this week we are going to meet an international chess player who has recently won the Grandmaster title and after that Commonwealth Games in 2019, and recently finished second place in Thailand tournament. In chess, India has witnessed the first Grandmaster during 1987, that is none other than Mr. Vishwanathan Anand, a chess legend. After that, India has witnessed lot of Grandmasters, and Indian is the 61st Grandmaster for India. And not only that, Indian is from non-metro city, is from E-Road. That too from a non-metro city, achieving at the top level, international level, is a remarkable thing. We are going to meet with him and chat with him. Hi Indian, welcome to our Sports Diary show.
Hello.
And many congratulations on behalf of Doordarshan for you on achieving your Grandmaster title recently in March, April.
Thank you.
So how was your feeling now?
I am feeling happy that I got the Grandmaster title. This was my aim from as long as I can remember.
Okay. And this time you have participated in the Thailand tournament also, right? And you finished second in that tournament.
Yes.
After that glorious Grandmaster title. So how do you feel this back-to-back victories for you?
After I became Grandmaster, I have had a string of good tournaments. I got tied for first in Dubai Open ahead of 30 or so ELO rating points ahead players. And then I got Commonwealth gold in under 18 category, and then Thailand Open was also good. I am feeling that I am playing well right now, and things are going well.
Tell us about that Noisiel Open in France, where you achieved that Grandmaster title. So how was the tournament for you right from the beginning?
I had just played the Aeroflot Open in Moscow before that, and I had played very well there, and required 5 points in my next tournament only. And I decided to participate in France in the last minute, and I went to the Noisiel Open, and I required 5 points, but in the second and third game, I drew against lower rated players and lost a lot of points. So I was not feeling well, because I need once more 10 points or more. And then I won 3 games continuously against good players, and that made me cross the 2500 rating mark, and I became Grandmaster there. And even after that, I had to continue the tournament. So there were 9 games, 6 were left, and there was 6 were played, and there were 3 still left, and I played those well and finished second there too.
Please tell us about your last 6 to 8 months before you achieved your Grandmaster title. How was that period for you?
I achieved my third GM norm in June of 2018, and that is the required number of norms, but I also had to get the rating 2500, and I was so close that it was just a matter of one or two good games that I could cross that. But somehow I slumped down, and then I had to come back again, but I couldn't manage to get past the 2490 rating points, and that was a period of struggle. I couldn't go forward too much.
And is that that 6 to 8 months period was a disturbing period for you? Like, you have already achieved 3 norms, but you are not able to get that rating points. So how was that?
It was not the 8 months, because after I got my norm, for 3 or 4 months I was it was not so much of a time, but after that it became a bit of frustrating for me.
Okay, tell us about that tournament held in Moscow. That also helped you to boost your confidence. So can you share that experience?
Yeah, I was playing in Aeroflot Open, and I needed 13 or 15 points in the tournament, and I played very well and got 10 points from the tournament. In fact, if I had drawn the last game, I would have got the GM title right then. But I was playing against a 2600 player. That is, he was 200 points ahead of me, and he was also having the white pieces, so it was difficult to get a draw there.
Okay, before getting this GM title, do you have that in your mind that if you win that match, you will achieve that GM title?
Yeah, before playing against Sergei Fedorchuk in the Noisiel Open, I know that if I win that, I will get the GM title. But since he is a 2600 player and he is a top seed of the tournament, it's not going to be easy to win against him. So I thought I will just go and play my best.
Inyan, at what age you started playing chess?
I am playing chess from the age of 5, and I went to an academy from the age of 6.
Okay, Inyan, what was the one thing that inspired you to choose chess than other outdoor games, or have you played any other sport before taking up the chess?
I think that at the age of 5, it is not a matter of us choosing. It is what our parents see that we are interested in, and what they think that it's good for us. At that time, I was already wearing spectacles, and also, so it will be a bit hard to play outdoor games, they thought, and they also thought that I'm quite interested in chess because they saw me playing in home. So that's why they chose chess for me. Before that, I did not play any other games, but after coming to chess, I used to play basketball in school and badminton quite well.
Okay, Inyan, where are you from? Basically, from Tamil Nadu, and which class you are studying, and from which school you are pursuing?
I am coming from Erode. It's a small district, and I am studying in the Indian Public School in 12th grade right now.
Okay, Inyan, generally sports players, they will come from metro cities, but you hail from a non-metro city, Erode. So how was that feeling for you, and what are the challenges that you have faced, and tell us about that experience.
It's quite difficult coming from a non-metro city. We face a lot of challenges. In my younger days, I used to play in a lot of federated tournaments, but all of them were used to being held in Chennai. So I had to travel for a day and stay in hotels instead of staying in home like most of my other competitors. And in the younger days, students like to have a face-to-face class, and a lot of people in Chennai can go to coaches who are in here itself. But my coach Vishweshwaran sir has been teaching me for the past 8 years, and if I have to come to his class, then I have to travel for a day and stay in some place. And if I take class in online, then it is not as effective as an face-to-face class. So there are quite a few difficulties, but these challenges are what makes us stronger and makes us who we are.
Please tell us about your coaches, who are very instrumental in your journey.
Yeah, it's true. A coach is very important in each person's career, and I have been lucky that I got very good coaches in my career. I have 3 coaches till now, and my first coach, Thirumurugan sir, was the one who took care of my basics. And then after a year, I moved to Senthilvel sir. He was in Salem, and I went to him for 3 years, no, 2 years. And then I went to Vishwesh sir for from my age of 9 till now, and he is coaching me to my next and next level.
Okay, Inyan, so how Mr. Vishweshwaran is playing a major role in your journey?
Vishweshwaran sir is helping me in a lot of ways. He clarifies my doubt. He works on my openings, middle games and end games. He makes me a better player. And during a tournament, if I have a doubt and I want to ask him, even if I am in a different time control and it's the middle of night, he is there to help us. And he has a lot of students who plays in different tournaments, and but he is always there when we need his help.
I train Inyan on various aspects of chess, provide him the necessary knowledge and on improving his skills to beat very strong opposition, both at the national level and the international level. So we work many hours a day. In Chennai, when he comes here, or online when we are not able to meet. Suppose he's traveling to international tournaments, we connect over Skype, and we have our training sessions. So we also plan how to strategies on beating very strong opponents, you know, which will help him to win the international level titles and championship. I'm also very glad he got the second place at the very recently held the Thailand International Open, and just before that, the Commonwealth Under 18 Championship.
I am V. Kameshwaran. I am fortunate to be India's first international arbiter in chess. Not only I trained some of the players in younger days like Vishwanathan Anand, Adiban, Sasikiran and others. And the most coincidence is my son K. Visveshwaran. K. Visveshwaran is an acclaimed FIDE trainee and he has trained more than 12 grandmasters. And the latest among his trainees is none other than 16-year-old Inian Panneerselvam. And I know the Inian who used to come to our place to learn chess from my son for the past 6 years. And I know him from the age of 9. He has to come all the way from Erode in a train, whether Erode Express or Intercity Express with his father. He will knock our door and enter into our training premises. He's such a nice boy. He's a very hard worker. Even though he's coming away from the main city of Chennai, he is much interested in chess and he learned a lot. And there is no doubt he has become now a grandmaster. And I wish him to go further, to compete with the top 100 in the coming years and be a challenger to Carlsen in the years to come.
Okay, and right from the beginning throughout your career, who are all supported you in your journey, whether it is going to a tournament or in terms of coaching coming to Chennai, can you please name the people who have supported you?
My coaches, obviously, and then my school. They have not only supported me morally but also financially in a lot of ways by exempting me from school fees and supporting me in other financial aids. And the foundation called Olirimi Road Foundation has been sponsoring me from the end of 2015 till now, and they have made me enabled to participate in about 30 international tournaments in abroad, and thanks for them. And also, ONGC has been sponsoring me with a scholarship for 2 years now, and right now a private company is sponsoring me.
Okay, last but not least, tell us about your parents' support.
My family has supported me a lot. My father, Panneerselvam, is working in the highways department, and he is the one who introduced me to the game and took me to the tournaments in my early stages of career. And he supported my career financially till 3 years back and completely, and even now he is supporting me financially. And my mother, Saranya, is a homemaker, and she travels with me to the tournaments a lot, and she takes care of my things and makes me enable to focus on my game. My sister Inikiti is studying in 7th grade in the same school as me, and she misses my mother a lot, and she sacrifices a lot for me, but she also prays and motivates me whenever I need that. And my grandmothers in both sides and my grandfather also supports me a lot, and not only morally but also financially they support me.
Okay, talking about finance, like you said, your father supported and also other family members. How meeting up the finance, especially going to a tournament, like you have travel, stay, food, coaching fee, entry fee, so how you meet out this?
Chess is quite an expensive game if you go to a higher level because you have to travel a lot, and for the first 7 years of my career my father did it completely alone, and my grandfather helped a bit. And for the past 3 years I had a sponsor called Olirimi Road Foundation, which tries to do good in my district and tries to develop my district. And I got lucky that I was a sportsman they decided to develop.
இனியன் வந்து 5 வயசாக இருக்கும்போது நாங்கள் செஸ் வந்து ஒரு ஸ்போர்ட்டில் வந்து இனியனை கொண்டு வரலாம் அப்படிங்கிறத தான் ஃபஸ்ட்டு டிசைட் பண்ணோம். ஏன்னா பேசிக்காக நான் வந்து டிஸ்ட்ரிக் லெவல் கிரிக்கெட்டர். அவனை ஸ்போர்ட்ஸில் ஏதாவது இன்டர்நேஷ்னல் லெவல் அச்சீவ் பண்ணுறதுக்கு பிளான் பண்ணும்போது ஃபஸ்ட்டு நாங்கள் சூஸ் பண்ணது செஸ்ஸை சூஸ் பண்ணோம். ஸோ அவனுக்கு அது வந்து மேட்ச் ஆச்சு. ஸோ 10 வருடங்கள் வந்து இது வரைக்கும் நிறைவடைஞ்சிருக்கு. ஸோ இந்த 10 வருடங்கள் நிறைவடையும் போது அவன் இன்டர்நேஷ்னல் அச்சீவ்மெண்ட் டைட்டில் வந்து பார்த்திங்கன்னா கிராண்ட் மாஸ்டர் டைட்டில் வந்து அச்சீவ் பண்ணியிருக்கான் செஸ்ஸில். இது ரொம்ப பெருமையாக இருக்குது எங்களுக்கு. இனியன் எவ்வளோ ஹார்ட் ஒர்க் பண்ணியிருக்கான் அப்படிங்கிற விஷயம் பார்த்தோம் அப்படின்னா, ஆல்மோஸ்ட் ஒரு வருஷத்தில் ஒரு 150 நாள்லேருந்து 200 நாள் வரைக்கும் நாங்கள் வந்து டோர்னமெண்ட்டுக்காகவும் கோச்சிங்க்காகவும் எங்கள் ஊர்லேருந்து வெளியே வர வேண்டியிருக்கும். ஒரு டோர்னமெண்ட் ஆடணும்னா மெட்ரோபாலிட்டன் சிட்டி, அதாவது சென்னை, பாம்பே, இல்லை வந்து டெல்லி, கல்கட்டா, இது மாதிரி டோர்னமெண்ட்ஸ் வந்து விளையாடுறதுக்காக நாங்கள் நிறையா ட்ராவல் பண்ண வேண்டியது இருந்துச்சு ஆரம்ப கட்டத்தில். ஸோ அதை தாண்டினதுக்கப்புறம் பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ஒரு லெவலுக்கு மேலே அவன் வரும்போது இன்டர்நேஷ்னல் டோர்னமெண்ட்ஸும் அவன் நிறையா பார்ட்டிசிபேட் பண்ண வேண்டிய சுச்சுவேஷன் வந்துச்சு. ஸோ ஒரு நாள் ஒரு 200 நாட்களுக்கு மேலே வந்து பார்த்திங்கன்னா ஒரு வருஷத்தில் நாங்கள் அவன் வந்து நிறையா ட்ராவல் பண்ணியிருக்கான் அப்படிங்கும்போது, ஸோ அந்த இடத்துல அவனுடைய ஹார்ட் ஒர்க் வந்து உண்மையாலுமே எங்களுக்கு வந்து அதுதான் எங்களை வந்து மோட்டிவேட் பண்ணிச்சு. ஏன்னா இதில் வந்து எங்களுக்கு ஃபினான்ஷியலாகவும் நிறையா ஸ்ட்ரகிள் இருந்துச்சு. ஸோ அதையெல்லாம் நாங்கள் வந்து தாண்டி அவனுக்கு வந்து அச்சீவ் பண்ண வைக்கும் போது பார்த்திங்கன்னா அவனுடைய ஆர்வமும் அவனுடைய உழைப்பும் தான் முக்கிய காரணமாக இருந்துச்சு. முக்கியமான ஒரு விஷயத்த நான் வந்து இங்கே குறிப்பிட விருந்தது, இனியன் அண்டர் 8 காமன்வெல்த் வந்து சில்வர் மெடல் பண்ணும்போது பொள்ளாச்சி மகாலிங்கம் ஐயா வந்து இனியனுக்கு ஒரு 1 lakh வந்து டொனேட் பண்ணார் அவனுடைய இன்டர்நேஷ்னல் டோர்னமெண்ட்ஸ்க்காக. அது வந்து எனக்கு எவ்வளோ பெருமையான விஷயம் அப்படின்னா, விஸ்வநாத ஆனந்த் வந்து கிராண்ட் மாஸ்டர் ஆகிறதுக்கு மகாலிங்கம் ஐயா வந்து ஒரு மிகப்பெரிய சப்போர்ட்டாக இருந்தார் அந்த காலத்தில். ஸோ அவர் கையால் இனியனுக்கு வந்து அந்த ஸ்பான்சர்ஷிப் ஃபஸ்ட்டாக கிடைச்சது அப்படிங்கிறது எனக்கு சென்டிமெண்ட்டாகவே நான் வந்து ரொம்ப அதை வந்து பெரிய விஷயமாக பார்த்தேன். ஸோ இனியனுக்கு இப்போது இனியன் கிராண்ட் மாஸ்டர் ஆனதுக்கப்புறம் அவனுக்கு வந்து சப்போர்ட் பண்ணுறதுக்காக, அவனுடைய மறுபடியும் ஃபர்தர் டெவலப்மெண்ட்காக சென்னை சேர்ந்த ஒரு தனியார் நிறுவனம் வந்து இப்போ ஸ்பான்சர் பண்ணதுக்கு முன்னாடி வந்திருக்காங்க. ஸோ அவங்களுக்கும் என்னுடைய நன்றியை தெரிவிச்சுக்கிறேன்.
ஓகே, இனியன், அப்பார்ட் ஃப்ரம் கெட்டிங் திஸ் ஜிஎம் இன் ஃப்ரான்ஸ் டோர்னமெண்ட், யூ ஹேட் அ விக்ட்ரி இன் காமன்வெல்த் கேம்ஸ் அண்ட் ஆல்சோ சேம் காமன்வெல்த் கேம்ஸ் டூரிங் 2016. டெல் அஸ் அபவுட் தட் காமன்வெல்த் விக்ட்ரி இன் 2016 அண்ட் 2019.
In 2016, the Commonwealth was held in Sri Lanka and I won the gold medal in the under-14 category, and this year the event was held in Delhi and I got gold in under-18 category. This was a bit tougher than the one previously because of the age and the toughness of the opponents, but still I managed to score a perfect 9 out of 9 in the 2016 as well as a perfect 7 out of 7 here, and I was the only one with a perfect score in all of the categories. There were 15 categories in total and I was the only one who got a full score here.
Yes, Indian, like how do you spend your free time and relax yourself and what are your hobbies?
I like to read books, a lot of books, and especially science fiction and mythology kind of books, and I also listen to music and do badminton and swimming.
Okay, so who is your role model and inspiration for choosing this game? Generally, sports players will see any idol who are from the same game or maybe another game. So like that, who is your role model?
My role model is Garry Kasparov, Viswanathan Anand and Magnus Carlsen. These three are very great players and legends of the game.
Talking about the legend Viswanathan Anand, India's first grandmaster and world champion, after you got this GM, we heard that he has tweeted you and wished you for your success and becoming the India's 61st GM. So how was that tweet for you?
It was greatly motivating to see that a great person like Anand is following us youngsters, and he sees what we do. And he tweeted before even the results were out, so he knew things beforehand. And I was greatly motivated and energized by his tweeting, and I hope to do more.
Okay, Indian, you are studying 12th standard now, a board exam. That also will create pressure for any student appearing for the board exam in 12th standard. So how do you manage your studies as well as the game?
No, I can study a lot faster than the normal student, and that is obviously helpful to me. For my 10th grade exams, for the public exam, I was playing in a tournament in Moscow and just came 10 days before the exams. And that was the time when I opened my books, and in the 10 days I studied, I still got 75%. So it's a bit easier for me with my mental powers.
Okay, you have played a lot of state tournaments, nationals and international. Can you recollect and name any memorable tournaments or matches played in state, national, international?
Okay, the first memorable moment was winning the second place in the nationals and qualifying for Asian and World in under-7 category. And then I got tied for bronze in the World under-8 category in Greece. That was definitely a very good moment. And then I got gold in the National Sub-Junior Championship. In all the categories, the sub-junior and junior categories are especially important, and it was nice that I got gold in the National Sub-Junior Championship. And then afterwards, Yeah, I got a lot of medals in the gold medals in the states, and in the international level, the Commonwealth gold is especially good, and I also got Asian sub junior silver medal.
Okay, any athlete or sports person will travel to different tournaments to different states and countries. They will that will have a lot of interesting facts. The player will have some memories. They would have lost their luggages, they would have not got the tickets. Like that, we heard some of the interesting incidents happened for you. Please tell us about that.
When I was going for the under 8 world championship in Greece, my visa got refused, and only through the efforts of our chess federation that I got the visa a few hours before we had to board the plane. So in this instance, I would also like to thank the chess federation, because they have supported me continuously, and without their constant support, it would not have been possible to achieve this title. And in 2016, I lost my laptop in Barcelona, Spain, and I had to play two more tournaments after that, but I played that without the laptop. And it is in a laptop that we store all kinds of information, and without it, it is like playing in a handicap. And also, in this year in Moscow, there was a bomb threat to the hotel that we are playing in, and during mid-game we had to leave the premises, and we had to go outside when it was in minus degrees in a normal clothes.
Okay, obviously losing a laptop is a big blow. Yeah. You said you had a lot of your data, personal data, and also the technical data. So after that blow, how you recovered and how you monitored your game, and without the data, how you perform? Is that affected your performance?
No, in fact, it greatly motivated me to play very well. And what I couldn't achieve in the previous tournaments, I achieved in the next two tournaments without my laptop. So I worked furiously during those two tournaments to make up for the lost laptop. And as I told, it is like playing with a handicap. So while my opponents could prepare very easily, and I couldn't do the same, but I still got my best game and got my IM title there only.
Okay, talking on laptop, generally laptop now when we are talking, people used to play the video games and all. Now the chess also having a feature that we can practice and play chess in online, and there is one format called Chess Base. Yeah. How do you practice and train? Do you practice manually in the board, or do you practice more in online?
During practice, we use both the online and the manual boards, and manual boards are better for because it makes us see things as in we see in a tournament. But we can't practice more in boards because the data are in the laptops, and we use a program called Chess Base because it makes things easier for us. It contains lots of previous games, and it enables us to prepare and search faster.
Okay, 2019 is a dream year for you. You got your GM March, April, then 2019 Commonwealth, and recently now in Thailand you finished second. So what is your next aim after having this incredible run in this year?
Okay, then my next aim is to play very well in the World Junior and World Youth Chess Championship. It is being held in India, and I want to get a medal in both of them. In the World Junior, only three Indian players have ever got a gold medal, and I would like to be the fourth player to become so. And in the meanwhile, former world champion Vladimir Kramnik is conducting a camp in Switzerland, and he has handpicked selected five players from the talented Indian youngsters, and I am one of them. So I'll be going there and try to learn a few things from him.
Yes, Indian. Nowadays, we are seeing a lot of young chess players like you making a mark internationally from Tamil Nadu, representing India. Say, example, yourself and Gukesh and Pragnananda. So, how do you see this as a healthy sign for India?
It's very good because we have a competition, and it's competition that takes us to the next level. And because of these guys, I also have to rise my game to the next level. And it goes the same to them. So, they have to go ahead.
Finally, I want to ask you, the viewers, especially the young viewers who are watching this game, youngsters who want to come up in sports, want to take up any sport like chess. Mm-hmm. So what do you want to say to the young buddies and young stars or young talents that you want to share any message?
I would like to tell them that you need to work hard, and success will be yours. You don't need to be deterred by losing, and you can see them as a stepping stone to success. I can say personally that losing games can occur in any kind of sport, and then you need to be confident in yourself, and you have to overcome them. Be strong, stay, be confident, and work hard. all the best.
Nice talking to you. Nice interview. We wish you all the best for your future tournaments.
Thank
and
you.
We want you to achieve more medals in many tournaments. All the very best.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, viewers, so we have witnessed a promising interview from a promising player, Inian. India's 61st Grandmaster, and in this year 2019 he has won the Grandmaster title as well as the Commonwealth Games and recently the tournament held in Thailand. So it's been an inspiring interview for all the young viewers who are watching this program. I will see you in another Sports Diary program with another international athlete. Till then, it's me, Dinesh, saying thank you very much from Sports Diary program.